introducing these two Road to Victory warriors once again. Fighting out of the blue corner, she represents the Lumpini Gym. She is Rina Green. And fighting out of the red corner, she represents Ken Shiro. She is Isabelle Barker.
It must be a world away for her, being up there in the cage.
Do you know what? I think it's very interesting for everyone to see her like this because, you know, she's a great, fantastic interviewer, does a great job holding the microphone, but, you know, we're going to see her in a completely different environment and we'll see how she adapts.
So they touch gloves. Nice kick from Isabelle, steps off beautifully. Comes forward nicely, spinning back fist.
Love. Now, do you know what's interesting to me from Isabelle is just how poised she is, how calm she is, how relaxed she is in there right now.
She's looking extremely composed. Parries the hand and lands a big one over the top.
Lovely right hand there.
She's looking very, very composed. Great movement. Rina moving well. Tries to circle, is he?
Lovely kick to the body from Isabelle.
Rina needs to come forward, take it.
Lovely. Just stepped right out the way, countered with a low kick. Beautiful technique from Isabelle there.
Yeah, she's looking extremely focused. Great at parrying those shots and she steps off really well.
So Rina's doing a good job. She's coming forward. She's just a little bit step behind.
Yeah, I'd like to see her just pick up the pace a little bit and put a bit more combinations together. She's single-shotting at the moment, whereas Isabelle is able to let go of 1, 2, 3.
Yeah, 100%. When it gets to it, if it does go to the scorecards, that's really going to make a big difference. Oh!
Was it a knockdown or a slip? It was a slip.
Well, listen, it looked like...
Great first round.
Listen, Rob, it looked like Rina was trying to close the show. Whether it was a knockdown or a slip, she said head kick coming anyway.
Here we go, round two. Very focused first round from Isabelle Barker. Looking very composed, very focused. And she's come out the same way for the second.
Listen,
great team.
Such an aggressive start from Isabelle. She came out focused.
Beautiful, nice left low kick. Rina coming forward now, trying to step through the shots.
But I like that from Rina. She's not shying away. She's coming forward. And she's landing her right hand a little bit better now.
That was nice.
Both teams have heeded advice from their corner. Isabelle with the captain, Ken Shiro, Kenny Moisten in her corner. Rina with the great Paolo Da Silva in her corner.
That was a nice combination. Isabelle looking very focused.
Lovely. I don't know if you guys at home can hear the sounds of these shots, but when Isabelle digs in these shots, it is tremendous.
Rina just trying to find her range. Needs to step forward slightly. Take it to Isabelle. At the moment, she's on the back foot, allowing Isabelle to dictate.
Do you know what it is, Rob? You spoke about this in the first round, about Rina only landing single shots. It's making it very difficult for her to get into a rhythm. Anytime she lands a shot, Isabelle's able to counter with one, two, three shots. Step off, she's not there. So it doesn't allow Rina to get into a smooth rhythm, for her to get her confidence to put two, three, four shots together. Both of these amazing warriors have a great corner team though, so I know if there's anyone that can advise Rina on how to turn this around, Paolo Da Silva is definitely someone that can do that. And if there's anyone that can help Isabella look for the finish, continue to push pressure, Kenny Moisten is someone that can get that done for sure.
So both fighters coming out for the last round. So far on the scorecards, of course unofficial, I have it two rounds to Isabelle.
Listen, let's get it clear, guys. The Rob Nutley scorecard is the only one that matters. Let's get that right.
If only that were true, eh?
Lovely right hand from Isabelle there.
Drives forward.
But I like that from Rina. She had her back towards the cage. She stepped off, created space, and got back into the open. I love that.
Nice kick to the body from Rina, starting to step up in this last round. Isabelle falls backwards, but beautiful right hand.
Beautiful
lands
right
twice.
Hand.
Beautiful. Solid, straight. Deep to the body. Nice catch from Rina. But again, even with that catch, she could have done more.
Yeah, listen, I feel like this fight is a great learning experience for both fighters. But I'll be honest, Rob, respectfully to both ladies, if you were not familiar with either of them, I think they have definitely shown you they are not just pretty faces.
Nice kick from Isabelle. Nice right hand. Doubled it up again.
Lovely right hand. And I love that adaption from Isabelle. She doubled up the right hand this time. Listen, fantastic fight for both fighters. I feel like they're going to learn a whole lot. I think Isabelle, I'll be honest, I think Isabelle's got this fight. But Rina's going to learn a whole lot from this. It's going to be a real great learning experience for her.
My apologies, I think I did say that it was the last round. Is it actually the third of five? My apologies.
Okay, I'm not going to lie to you. I was definitely talking as if that was the last round. But it's okay. More fun for everyone.
So this one, five rounds.
So that's now very interesting, because it is five rounds now. That gives a great opportunity. There's two rounds here that Rina has to turn this around, to apply the pressure, break Isabelle down. The only problem is that Isabelle has not shown us any sign of slowing down. Rob, it'll be interesting to see from the blue corner with Rina, what information has her corner given her, and is she able to implement it?
Well, now she's starting to throw together combinations.
Something I just noticed as well from Isabelle, she's been throwing a really hard teep to the right leg of Rina, and I didn't even realize how much damage that teep has been doing.
Yeah, it's a nice stopper when... Oh, that was a nice connection. It's a nice stopper when someone's coming forward to keep the fight. Again, Izzy looking for that spinning back fist.
Listen, the spinning back fist almost turned into a spinning elbow.
Good movement again, just steps off really well.
Do you know what? Isabelle's doing such an amazing job stepping off of that. But I would love to see her. She now knows she can get out of the way of that counter. So counter that yourself.
Beautiful work from Rina there. She went to the right-hand side, left body kick. Again, that spinning back fist. There's blood there somewhere.
Somebody's bleeding.
I think it maybe is about.
Lovely clinch and knee to the body from Rina.
Rina coming into her own now. As you said, a couple of rounds left.
Oh, Isabel's bleeding.
Good trade of knees.
So look, we said this, Rob. There's two rounds left, which makes the fight incredibly interesting. Isabelle is busted up. She's bleeding. There's Clara all over the gaff. That is going to give Rina so much confidence. She was able to press forward, land right hands, and she had success in that clinch as well. So I'll be interested to see if she goes to that in the final round. Now, guys, I know we've said this before about the final round, but this time we promise it. This is the final, fifth and final round.
The last round.
Isabelle and Rina representing for the ladies. Big bombs.
Take down into armbar.
Listen, this is what I like. Mix up the sports.
Wow. Now they're going at it. Rina really pushing the pace now in this last round. Isabelle clinching, fires those knees. Good work by Rina, just getting that knee in between them.
It's very interesting. Early in the fight, we weren't really seeing them clinch too much, so now we're seeing it near the end.
Yeah, the tiredness is taking its toll. Rina pushing the pace now. Steps in with that body shot. Beautiful. Oh.
Rob, I think she heard you about takedown into armbar. It looked like she was going for an armbar right then. Big right hand there from Isabella.
Three in a row. And the sweep. Beautiful. Textbook beauty.
Isabelle's face is covered in blood. Oh, beautiful right hand.
Over the top.
Listen.
Wow.
Both ladies can raise their hands in the air. They are both warriors. Absolutely phenomenal fight.
That was fantastic. Both ladies giving their all. Took Rina a little while to get going for me though.
Yeah, no, 100%. After the third round, the fourth and fifth round, she really came into her own, especially the fourth round there. But I think sometimes with fighters, it takes them a little while to get into their groove. But, you know, I think Rina's a five-round fighter, and I think she really pushed on in the final round. But bottom line, I think Isabella got that.
I think it also comes as well from traditional Muay Thai, where the first few rounds are generally a feeling out process. And then as the fight moves on, the fights get harder and faster and deeper, and the music gets more powerful and faster and deeper, and you know, suddenly you're in this fight in the final two rounds. It's quite strange to watch as a spectator.
Yeah, especially if you're not familiar with it. You wonder, why in the first round they going so lightly? What's going on? But, you know.
And then by the end, you're wondering why they didn't do that in the first round. But yeah, great to see and fantastic. Fantastic fight.
But Rob, you did mention the music, and I do think we should consider that moving forward. Traditional Muay Thai music as the fights are going. Good shout. I'm not sure what the confusion is in the cage. Something's going on.
I think we're just waiting for our official decision. And I wouldn't be surprised.
Ladies and gentlemen, once again, before I announce the decision, make some noise for both these girls. What a fight!
If the red corner did not get their hands raised, I would be
flabbergasted. Fantastic rounds of Road to Victory Muay Thai action. We go to the judges' scorecards and we have a unanimous decision in favor of your winner, representing Kenshiro, Isabelle.